Hi, people and beings. I really love beings. Today, Uranus. Oh, actually, I was going to start with Saturn and Pluto, but I am on to something. I'm so excited about it. Okay, so today is a huge day. And so I want to talk about the next 10 to 36 years. Let's write that down so I don't forget. 10 to 36 years. So Pluto and Saturn are getting married today. Thank you, Ann Ortley. I love you. But it's commitment, right? So if we're planning the next 36 years, no dystopian fantasies, please. We do not need that kind of energy. We need envisionaries. I say envision fairies, but when you spell it, I'm excited and I'm getting off track. Let's ground this energy. Okay. So we live in a clock, yeah? A simulation, a clock, whatever. But we're essentially going in circles. So inside the center of Mother Earth, a crystal. And I built myself a home inside that crystal. And then breathe from that space. So getting down there is a lot of work. And we have Alchemy 101 for Pluto Return, American Revolution 2.0. I love that name. To help with the layers it takes to get to that crystal and to be able to like build yourself a home in there. Pluto takes 250 years. Astrology is math. 250 years. Pluto moved into Capricorn 2008, and it will be through 2022. Today, Saturn and Pluto are conjunct. Yeah? Yeah, this is huge. I mean, it's huge. It's so huge, you like might not even notice until later. It's like it ripples throughout your life. So Pluto is in Capricorn. Saturn is in Capricorn. They're at the same degree. That's what conjunct means. Uranus is in Taurus. It just moved direct. Full moon. The last time this was, did I not write it down? Yeah, Nazi G and the rise of dictatorships and the rise of science, you know, stealing the scientists. It's always science wars, really. So this is where we are, right? These themes, and we'll get into Saturn in a second. Because we're actually at a kind of a unique time with Uranus and Taurus at the same time that we're in our Pluto return, which is the American Revolution, right? So the rise of science, I'm specifically looking at the Space Wars, I'm sorry, Space Force and Mauna Kea. For all of you who are just sucked into that Star Wars fandom, pull yourself out and recognize where it's happening in your reality. And maybe, you know, live for real. Gosh, how exciting. Okay, so, and I've been in Game of Wars. No, what is it? Game of Thrones fandom before. So I don't mean it like that. I just mean also participate in your reality. Don't only participate. I participate at every level. Don't only participate via TV. Also participate, you know, in reality. All of them. So, Uranus Taurus, science, stealing of scientists in a new way. Mauna Kea, Hawaii. TMT. I'll post a link regarding telescopes and how the military uses them, and corporations use them, to large organizations like NGOs rather than governments, is what I meant by corporations. We'll use the telescopes to knock out satellites, and there's just a whole lot going on out there. And so TMT is trying to desecrate a sacred Mauna, which is also a communication system in itself. Like, Mauna Kea is the telescope. It is the crystal ball. It's the communication system. The telescope will knock out, I mean, if you are a receiver or a channel or a conduit, if you consider yourself a reader, really, I'm surprised more readers, witches, aren't into more sacred activism. I know a lot of us are. But particularly, like the Burning Man crowd, maybe. Burning Man crowd, please also get involved in Mauna Kea. Or, this is what we're doing, Pluto, Saturn, what are you going to commit to? Are you going to commit to healing the Earth, Uranus, Taurus? Or are you going to commit to capitalism, you know? Also very, very Taurus. Maybe not capitalism in itself, but the money and how we're in a serious hierarchy right now. So what are you committing to for the next 36 years? Because with our nodes in Capricorn, Cancer right now, Cancer, Capricorn right now, they're going to be moving into Aquarius. Pluto, 2022-23, moving. What comes after Capricorn? Aquarius. So right now we're really examining the family, Capricorn, Cancer, the mother, Earth, patriarchy. Yeah? And then we're going to move into Aquarius. Also, a lot is going to be moving into Aquarius. So then if it takes Pluto some time to move through a sign, 2008-2022, that's time. That's math. We'll be in Aquarius for a while. Neptune is in Pisces. This is also a big factor because, we can really dream big. Enough with the dystopian nightmares, people. Jeez. Envision a better world. And then make it. I put on Nextdoor. If anybody's not on Nextdoor, I highly recommend it. It's great for your community to kind of see what's going on locally. But there's an abandoned lot next door. And I put out that I was going to clean it. So many people were worried about the property owner's feelings. Like they matter. I mean, they do, but at the same time, if you're going to abandon a lot and then leave garbage there, I'm not really worried about how you feel. You've obviously got some stuff going on. Go heal it. Sell your land. Give your land. God, land. Reclaiming land. Uranus Taurus. Let's reclaim it. It's ours. If you live on Earth, you know, borders. Oh my God, Saturn. Yeah, let's figure this out. So, because we're going to be moving into our Renaissance. And what's that going to look like? There's a lot of darkness before Renaissance. See? So this is where we be the light. Oh my gosh, yeah, be the change, be the light. It really does work. Self-care, self-love, healing thyself, working on thyself, commits to the collective. I mean, all of these themes are coming up. I mean, we're all talking about them. We just don't realize that we're talking about them also in the context of astrology. Systems. I mean, it's all systems. Themes. Yeah, Star Wars fandom. Convert. I've never actually seen Star Wars, but I heard a Yoda thing going, and I was like, this sounds like an allegory for World War II. So, we are at that time again. I propose, instead of Star Wars, we stars peace, maybe? Yeah? Revolution in gardening. So, Saturn, Pluto today. I'm committing to self-love. Mother Earth, as always. Mother Earth, I love you so much. Thank you. And thank you for loving me, Mother Earth. Snowflake asterisk, universe, Mother Earth, find your language. I'm very much about the goddess energy, but I'm also very blended in my masculine and feminine. Everybody can be a goddess. Wow, so think about the next 36 years, the next 10 years. Take a broader vision. What you want to create, considering the energies and themes that are coming up. We're doing it. I feel great. I hope everyone feels great. Ground this energy in love. My heart chakra is like, wow.